Hi there, my name is Vadim Mikhailenko from howtoanalyzedata.net. In this section, we're going to look at how to create a first Visio diagram. When you launch the application, the first screen you see is this, where you can see some featured types of diagrams or different categories. And you can also search online templates for Microsoft Visio diagrams. So the number one is the basic diagram. You also can do a blank drawing. You can also take a tour and learn a little bit about the tool. And also you have a lot of different choices based on the business specialty of what you're trying to accomplish. For example, you can do a basic flow chart. You can do organizational chart, detailed network diagram, timeline, cross-functional flow chart, workflow diagram, and a lot of others. I'm not going to list all of them, but you can kind of scroll down the list and see what are the options that are available. What I'm going to do, I'm going to select the basic diagram, and there are different types of units that you can select. Within the United States, you would want to select United States units, US units, and click Create button. So based on your selection, you can see different stencil that's available. You can have a quick shapes, and these are the basic shapes in the United States units. We can have basic shapes, we can have arrow shapes, decorative shapes, graph and math shapes. These choices give you opportunity to select a different shape and create your diagram. You can select the object that you're looking for, and you can drag it. And you can combine objects from different sections. For example, I can do object from the graph and math shapes, and I can do an arrow shape object, and I can bring something from the basic shaped object. Now I'm going to discard this diagram and create a new one. And now instead of selecting basic shape, I'm going to do a basic flow chart. I'm also going to pick US units, and then I'm going to click Create. And you see that my selection of shapes now is very different from the previous one. I only have quick shapes, basic flowchart shapes, and cross-functional flowchart shapes. So now I can build a flowchart diagram. I can have a process. And now you see with process, I can do continuous diagrams. For example, I can select a different type of shapes as the next one, and it will automatically be connected. And as I navigate, it helps me build the diagram because I can extend the next shape depending the direction I would like to go next. Now, what I'm going to do, let's say that this is not a satisfactory list for me, and I'm looking for something very special. What I can do, I can add more shapes, and there are multiple ways to do it. One way for me is to create more shapes and just look through what's available and then select it. And you see I added integrated circuit components, and it added additional sections in the shape section. So now I can use it to find the components I'm looking for. Another way to do it is click on the search button and search for the object that you're looking for. It's not going to bring the whole section, but it can help you find what you might be looking for. In my case, I'm looking for server, and this would be a special shape of server that I'll be able to bring in. Sometimes it takes a little bit longer because it might go to Microsoft Office online to find the required object. And as you can see, it found different types of servers that are available that I can bring in into my diagram. I can scroll and pick the right one that fit my needs the best. Thank you for watching. I hope you found this information valuable and enjoyed the video. Please make sure to check out my other videos on the subject, and please make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, if you want to learn more about Visio tips and techniques, you can do it on my website at www.howtoanalyzedata.net/visio. You can also check out the Visio training I recommend by going to www.howtoanalyzedata.net/visio training, and make sure to sign up for my email list. I'll keep you posted on the tips, tricks, and techniques and other promotions available. You can do it at www.howtoanalyzedata.net/email. See you next time.